Hi everyone, Sleepthany Sack Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for a review of the new Guppy album, None. This is the debut full-length album of California electronic music producer, Guppy, an artist I first came across a few weeks ago off hearing one of my favorite singles of the year so far, Thosmoser, featuring Fraxium. A groovy bubblegum bass banger with zany lead vocals, atomic bomb beats, driving house grooves, also, what is that bar, check? Like Caroline Pola, bar of the year. Guppy's output didn't always sound this way though. You could say at this point Guppy is still an artist who is finding his footing, as he still has a relatively small following and his sound has evolved pretty rapidly over the course of the past several years, over which he's released a few EPs, a string of singles dating back to 2016, and over that course of time Guppy has jumped from genre to genre to genre, from EDM to trap to dubstep, electro house, bitpop. And even though None sees Guppy undergoing another step of evolution, a lot of these sounds and styles still culminate on this new LP, with all of them being filtered through this freaky, jittery production style that shares parallels with 100 Gex, Rusty, Igloo Ghost, PC Music, video game soundtracks too. It's a mix of very bright, hyper, punchy sounds with overt nods to EDM and pop, presented with a lot of high tempos, a lot of noisy, abrasive textures. In a way, you could say the sound of this record is very accurately represented by the cover art. A lot of strong contrast between the sounds, lines everywhere drawing your eyes in different directions, crude veneer, but methodical assembly. You can sort of take the intro track, None, as the record's MO. A very triumphant build of beautiful, bright arpeggios topped with these zipping, zippy, whooshing synth leads that just slice through the mix like a high-powered laser. It dazzles, but it also burns and grooves really hard too once those kicks kick in. Now, it's not the most original or even the most entertaining track in the tracklist, but it does have a great pace, great energy, and a mood that carries throughout the rest of the record pretty consistently. We then have the even catchier Modest, which is more digitally sugar-coated dance pop, but now it's topped with these chipmunk vocals that are touched up in a way that it sounds like I'm listening to a robot singing, or a Vocaloid, or a character from Animal Crossing. It's a bit grating in a way, but still a very well-assembled piece of tightly wound pop. Meanwhile, with the track Paradise, the intensity gets even higher with these ultra jittery beats and synths that make me feel like I am flying down some kind of mass transit tube, passing by lights at 1,000 miles an hour in lots of futuristic city scenery. Also love the track's dark intro, the EDM style buildups, as well as the anthemic synth leads that play throughout. However, the synths are a little hard to interpret as they have a very strange timbre to them. The melodies they're playing are uplifting and exciting, especially at the tempo they're being played, but there's something about how they're warped that just makes them feel a little demented and unsettling. Meanwhile, the track Plymouth Simulation stands out for its little dubstep nods, delivering many of the same bustling synths and beats and buildups you've heard so far, but now with these massive hits of bass and hard drops. Pulling from pretty much the same sound in an even more explosive way is Driving Directly Into a Concrete Wall, which is a song title. With its earthquaking, booming, robust, my 600-pound life bass that hits like a Mack truck with 10 trailers behind it of Fiji water. We then see another stylistic shift on the track Regression, which sputters along like a somewhat old-school piece of IDM or techno. Now, of course, even with this change, Guppy is delivering these grooves, these beats, these sequences in a very similarly abrasive style, which, as we're this deep into the record, does get a little tiring. I would hope a project with 11 tracks on it would be a bit more sonically varied than this, as some of Guppy's buildups and melodic progressions do get a little redundant, or even derivative, like in the case of Spencer Adventure 2. And admittedly, I don't quite see what False Awakening brings to the tracklist here that other tracks don't, or at least wasn't done better on other cuts. I mean, it's not bad, it's another nice and fast and very hyper piece of chipmunked electronic pop, but there's not much to it that really stands out in this tracklist of very samey sounding songs, especially with the singing sounding so weak and being so buried in the mix. The record's true highlight is actually Thosmoser, which is this Frankenstein monster of bubblegum bass and house and a little hip hop in there too. Fraxium's vocal contributions really make the track. I love how absurd and irreverent a lot of the lyrics are. Give a fuck what my schedule says. I won't give a fuck till I'm fucking dead. Give a fuck what my schedule says. Fuck Notch, fuck Musk, and I'll piss on Zed. The attitude is very punk, and topically it's like a shotgun spray, but there are notes of the lyrics that read to me as stimulation overload in the information age. Faking It is another stylistic switch up, as the track just pulses so quickly, like a piece of very intense gabber music. Meanwhile, Delusion is a very grand ending to the record, with the chord progressions and the melodies sounding much more regal than they are on any other track here. It's like Guppy is trying to really pull from either classical music or even rock opera to polish this thing off. Overall, I think this is a pretty fun collection of tracks. Even if the sound overall is a bit one-dimensional, I think this project really could have used either more features, definitely different instrumental palettes, that is for sure. But what I can say is that there are a lot of bangers on here. A lot of very colorful, kooky, intense, smile-inducing bangers with a lot of personality, a wide array of influences from the worlds of pop and electronic music. Yeah, you could say that what Guppy is doing stylistically is very much trendy and in line with much of what we're hearing out of the bubblegum bass scene right now, but it seems like there's enough potential and talent here to really carve out a niche within it, and I guess we'll see when or if that happens. Feeling a strong 6 to a light 7 on this one. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Why? What do you think I should review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video for you to check out and the link to subscribe to the channel too. You're the best. Anthony Fantano, Guppy, forever.